The Department of Justice is confident with the direction of the Percy Lapid investigation. Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla said they may file cases next week on the murder of the veteran journalist.
Very satisfactory. I think we've made a lot of progress. I think that we can... The proper cases can be filed by the end of next week, hopefully.
According to Remulla, it is also likely that they'll identify the mastermind.
Very possible. It's very possible. We have to evaluate everything. Just guiding the investigation and guiding it through to make sure that it carries on.
In the joint investigation of the PNP and NBI, they've already taken sworn statements from four inmates in the New Bilibid prisons who are considered persons of interest. According to the DOJ, their statements have been cohesive.
Statements were made, okay, and we're trying to make sure na itatahi muna natin yung mga statements na ito to make sure that we have an airtight case. As of right now, the last thing we want is for people to jump into conclusions. So what we want to do is we want to make sure muna na itong mga statements ay i-verify muna natin because we also can't believe it on face value.
In the sworn statement of one of the inmates obtained by ABS-CBN News, some of the details were consistent with the statement released by alias Marisa. Marisa received text messages from his brother, Jun Villamor, before he died and was identified as the middleman in the murder of Lapid. One of the messages mentioned the names of the commanders of three gangs in the NBP, Batang City Jail, Sputnik Gang, and Happy Go Lucky. In the affidavit of the inmate, the three groups were mentioned again. The tasks of those involved in the planning of the murder were compartmentalized. Each had limited information on what they knew about the plan, and not all knew the details and who were involved in the crime. Coordination with a self-confessed gunman, Joel Escorial, was tasked to another person. The inmate also revealed that they raised the funds needed to pay the gunman for the murder and how to deposit the money in the gunman's bank account. The inmate also narrated that they were threatened to execute the plan sooner. The inmates will remain in the NBI's custody while the investigation is ongoing. The NBI has also taken into custody a fifth inmate who is also asked to cooperate in the investigation. In the meantime, results of the independent autopsy on the body of alleged middleman Jun Villamor will be out on Saturday. Dr. Raquel Fortun was initially set to release her findings Friday, but she asked for another day to finish her report.
I did hear that she wanted to come up with a thorough, at least 6 pages daw yung magiging report niya. So I think she just wants to be thorough. She understands the gravity of the report that she's creating or she's making. So I'm sure that Dr. Raquel Fortun is just being diligent, no, in her work.
The NBI says they will also give an opportunity for personalities who might be implicated in the investigation to explain themselves and present their side.